doesn't love seafood salad? I'm satisfied with life. I do not just get by, I thrive.
What a miracle to be up and alive. Welcome back to my channel. Before we get started, like, comment, and subscribe. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna put some crab boil into our water, and of course that's Old Bay, and then we're gonna put a little lemon zest, and what that's gonna do is create a nice little bath for our shrimp to get going in. Now, if you're wondering, we're using lemon zest because that's actually gonna impart that lemon oil flavor. If you put lemon juice in a hot boiling water, it's really gonna get lost and you're really not gonna carry over that lemon that we want on our shrimp. Now I have a good bowl with my flavored water, and then we're basically gonna like poach this shrimp, right? We don't need to bring it to a boil. What I'm looking for is the color to turn pink and for the shrimp to curl and no longer be translucent. Soon as that happens, we're gonna take them off and then we're gonna start cooling them down so we can add them into our salad. Don't keep your shrimp on there too long. If they're a very tight curl, they're gonna be overcooked and they won't be tender. We want tender shrimp in our seafood pasta salad.
Now keep in mind, as these shrimp cool, they're gonna cook a little bit more. So you see how they're nice and bouncy and no longer a translucent. This is exactly where you want to pull them. Alright, now I just put my pasta right into that seasoned water. You know, you have the shrimp in there, you have the seasoning, it's all good to go. Add more water if you need to. And you're just going to cook whatever your chosen pasta is by the instructions on the box. Now I've cooled both the pasta and the shrimp down before adding them together. Now I'm taking jumbo lump crab meat. Jumbo lump is more expensive than back fin or other varieties, but I like to rinse mine. And then once it drains off, put it in there because it is sitting in a water and it could be briny, so you don't want that. If you want to cut corners, you absolutely can omit this, or you can get the cheaper back fin or other picks of crab. Now I'm just gonna break up the lump crab meat with my hand. This is totally optional. You break it up to your liking. Some people like the bigger pieces in it, but I add noodle, and over the years I've added noodles, and I've also broken up my crab meat because we want this to spread and serve a lot of people, or just have a little bit more weight to it, because this is an expensive dish when you're talking about the lump crab meat and the shrimp and all that. And whatever other seafoods you choose to put in there, you can even put scallops in there. But the pasta is going to give it a little bit more stretch. And I just like to have a good bite of all meats in each forkful. So that's why I like to break up my crab. So I know imitation crab meat is going to be controversial for some. I have found that it adds a nice sweetness to my dish. And you know, economy, if you want this dish to bulk up some, it's a great addition. If you don't like it, don't use it. This is your meal. Any of these ingredients that you don't particularly like or you want to swap out, that's fine. I will make a note. I've never put tuna fish in my seafood salad, and I know some people do. I choose not to because I like the sweeter pieces of meat. So we're talking about the shrimp, the crab, scallop, even the imitation crab, right? When you add tuna fish, it's a very strong flavor and it's gonna kind of change the cadence of this. And I can't say that the spices are the right spices and the right mix. So just keep that in mind. All right, so I'm gonna get the seasoning, my salad. I'm gonna add the juice of about a half a lemon, and you can adjust it as you go on. Again, this is a cold dish, so at this time we're safe to add the lemon juice and have a good flavor. Of course, I'm from Maryland, so you know we're gonna do Old Bay, but you can really use, again, customize this recipe if you prefer another season, by all means use it. But again, these ingredients are based around a Maryland type of style. Next, we're gonna add some mayo. I'm using Duke's. I think it has kind of a lemony flavor on it, but you can use whatever your favorite mayo is. I would not use Miracle Whip
or any variation of that because it's sweet, and we really want to bring the sweetness out of our meat, our seafood. And so I wouldn't do it, but hey, this is yours, so if you want to do it, by all means, you can absolutely do that. You'll notice I add modest amounts of all of my seasonings because you can always add more, but you can't take it away. Now I'm gonna put a dash of Worcestershire sauce. I know that might seem a little crazy, but it's gonna bring umami and roundness, and this really mimics a Maryland style crab cake, where you're gonna use Worcestershire as well as, of course, mustard. You can use Dijon. I didn't have any Dijon, so I used yellow, and it works just fine. Just a note on the mustard and the Worcestershire, it is strong flavor, so do not overdo it. Just start with a dash. Now, I chose to use shallot. I had it on hand, but you can most certainly use red onion. Shallots have a more delicate flavor, and I find that they are a better pairing for seafood, but of course you can use red onion. You can even soak your red onion in cold water if you want to bring down the sharpness of it a little bit. But if you prefer that sharpness, of course, use red onion. Again, customized to your taste.
All right, now you're gonna see my first adjustment. Pasta absorbs. So you're always gonna have to add a little mayo when you're making a cold pasta dish. That's normal, be prepared for that. And also anticipate the longer it sits, the more it's gonna absorb. So you might wanna go a touch over. Next, I'm gonna add some garlic powder.
Also, I'm gonna add some onion powder, and I'm gonna do a wrist of both. Now, a wrist is when you just like do a spin of the bottle. You know, people call it a wrist. But if you need a measurement, most of my measurements start with like a half a teaspoon. Unless it's a bigger pot, then you'll see me do a little bit more. But that's a good starting point. Now you're gonna see me do some adjustment. I'm gonna add just a splash more Worcestershire and go in with a little bit more onion. And again, always be modest with your seasoning. Taste it, mix it. I sometimes even let mine sit a little bit because as the seasoning sits, it gets a little stronger and you can actually taste it. So I'm just gonna keep on adjusting until I get it where I wanna get it. What we're looking for, we don't want it to be dry. If you're kind of flat and baseless, like a little blah, that might need some umami with the Worcestershire sauce. And then of course you need salt, you're gonna add Old Bay. So those are the ways you can spin. If you want a little bit more freshness and lift it up, then you would add more lemon juice. So this one was really fun, it's easy, it's so good. And I suggest you try it and customize it. You can always add fresh herbs if you like to. I just like to give you some real like master recipes that are a beginning point, a solid beginning that you can customize. So you have the idea of the moisture, you have the idea of flavor profile. If you want to add something to it, by all means. And doesn't this look beautiful? So I hope you'll come back through. Leave me a comment if there's something you have a question about or if something you want me to cook. And until next time, thank you for watching and I'll see you again. Oh yeah, don't forget to subscribe. Do that. Thanks.